In the last tutorial, we learned how to make a pretty interesting lower third title in Premiere itself. So you can see this one title animates on using an animated position, and the other one fades on using animated opacity. And that's fine, but what if I wanted to have transparent text so I can see the background through it, or see video footage through the text? Or what if I wanted to have something that's beyond just a wedge or a rectangle in my graphics? Or what if I wanted something else? And more importantly, what if I wanted to be able to warp it or twist it or do all sorts of things with effects that I can do in Photoshop that I can't do in Premiere? Well, the thing is, because you're using an Adobe product, it's really easy to just import one thing into another. So what I'm going to do is open Photoshop, and you can see I have a finished project here, which looks kind of similar to the other one. And you notice that there are four layers here. I only need three, actually. I don't need the background. And I'll show you how to do this. I'm going to go to make a new file, and I'm going to make it 1920 by 1080 because that's the resolution of my HD sequence here. And it has a background. I'm going to go ahead and make a new layer, delete the background out. And then I'm just going to use my brush tool and use a nice color, a nice red here, to be able to make some kind of spray paint or squiggle look that I could never get in Photoshop itself. I'm sorry, in Premiere itself. And of course, notice that I could, in fact, leave big chunks missing out of this so you have the background behind it. That gives me a pretty decent splotch of color there. And of course, you could do anything with this. You could have images, you could have really complex graphics, multiple colors, different things with opacity and blurring and different effects. All those things that you can do in Photoshop, which is such a complex, wonderful tool. But here, I'm just going to add a very simple text layer on top of it. I'm going to call it CMC Productions. And this looks like it's about the right size. But in fact, I think I'm going to make this a little bit bigger, maybe 35 or so. That's way too big. So we might go to maybe 32, 31. Oops. 31, and that's about right. Maybe it's a little too small, so let's try for 32. And what I want is for it to be very obvious that this is actually interfering with the background, that that the red here is mixing with the piece. And I could actually do that by erasing bits of the background itself. So I'm gonna make this eraser a little bit smaller and see if I can cut out some pieces here, maybe from the S or something like that, just to make it really seem like we are we're cutting these pieces out. You know, not the best way to do it, so you know, I'll leave it at this, and you can play with it on your own. But this is not where I want to stop, because if I imported this into Premiere, even if it was in two layers that were animatable. I would still have white text. So what I'm going to do is click on my CMC Productions thing, right-click our option, and go to not rasterize type, which would make it white, but instead I want to just select the pixel. So you can't right-click on CMC Productions here. You have to do it on the type layer itself. Notice there's two different areas that you can click. So I'm going to right-click, select pixels, and this is a wonderful thing to use when you're working with text. I'm going to duplicate this layer by dragging the layer 1 down here. So I've got two on top of one another. And then in this one, I'm just going to press delete. And you might not see that anything has happened here. But if you make the text invisible and you make the background invisible, you can actually see that this is transparent here. If I zoom in, you can see that's not white anymore. It's actually a cutout, transparent cutout, which is really, really cool. So when I want to take this in, I'm actually going to keep all three layers together, and I'll show you why in a second. So I have to save this file, so file save as, and I'm going to save it as CMC Productions logo 2, and I'm going to maximize compatibility, although it doesn't really matter. When I go back into Premiere, what I'm going to do is just import this file. When you do that, it gives you a bunch of options, but one of them is merge all layers, which you never really want. What I'm going to do is do it as individual layers. Normally I would do it as a sequence, which would make it as a separate little movie that you could embed in. But here it doesn't really matter because I don't have too many layers, so I'll do it as individual layers. And I want all three layers to be brought in just in case I need them. The cool thing about using Photoshop and Premiere is that as soon as you open that piece back in Photoshop and edit it and save it, it will automatically alter it in Premiere or in After Effects or whatever you're doing. It's the wonderful thing about using Adobe products together. Now, the interesting thing here is that that is exactly like a smart object in Photoshop. So you should be familiar with this process already if you know anything about Photoshop. Notice that it creates a bin, so it's already organized it for you. And then it gives you your logos on top of one another. The first thing that I want to do is actually bring in my layer one, which is the background layer. So it looks like this. And I'm going to animate this on. So I'm going to animate my opacity so that it fades in. So let's say it starts here, 100%, go back to the beginning, and then drag it down to zero. So this fades on. Then what I need to do is actually fade on the other one on top of this. And the reason is that I want to be able to feel like this piece is together. So I'm going to drag, in this case, the opacity down to zero. And then I'm going to drag it forward a little bit in time and bring it up to 100%. Now, the reason why I do this is that if you animate this on and then have the other one just pop on at the same time, because these edges are blurred, it will look really, really strange. So you always have to animate one on top of the other. Once I'm here, though, what I need to do is animate off this bottom one to reveal that transparent text in the background. So I want to go back here and animate off this bottom layer. So you can see that what I'm doing is actually animating one on, animating the other on, and then removing that piece. So it actually removes the red at the same time. You could drag this out a little further. There's a whole bunch of things you could do to change that look. But this gives you a pretty complex project here. And notice that if I make this full screen, or make it larger, sorry, you can actually see the background behind this. So it gives you a much more variegated text. So here it's bright, here it's dark because I've got a lighting effect on this color mat. But if I had video footage behind this, driving or some kind of B-roll, even A-roll, so an interview, you would actually see that movement behind this text. So it gives you a really, really nice look. I hope you enjoyed it. Good luck.